Zoom have added more abilities. In the last 6 months, Zoom have added mail and calendar, and it really does add a layer to your Zoom account for practicality and use, but does it really become useful when you're using it? Today, we're going to explore Zoom Mail and Zoom Calendar now that they are out of beta and give you an idea of how they work and a little bit more about them. So welcome, my name is Francesco D'Alessio. I'm very excited to dive into Zoom and many of the other productivity apps. So if you're new here, hit subscribe and also check out Tool Finder, which will be linked in the description below. Today's video is brought to you by Freedom. Now, for those who don't know what Freedom is, it's an application that allows you to block websites and apps and distractions and help you to focus in on what matters. So I want to highlight three things that Freedom does really well. The first of those is to work across all of your devices to not only block websites, but apps as well, so that you can block those distractions that are getting in the way of deep focused work. And it can do that all at the same time across all of your devices. Now, secondly, you can also schedule a focus session or actually create recurring sessions as well, so that you can really set time on what matters and really align that to what you're working on during the day. You can also use focus sounds to improve the intensity of those sessions as well inside of the Freedom app. And finally, there is a locked mode, which can really be the beast mode activation for your distractions. It really will lock you in and stop you from using these different apps and websites and really help those on those days that particularly willpower is bad. Now, Freedom is used by over 2.5 million people around the world, students, entrepreneurs, professionals alike, that really want to get some better focus. And a Freedom users report says it saves them around 2.5 hours a day in time. And that focus time is really important to really get things done that matter to you. So you can check out Freedom in the link in the description, and a big thanks to Freedom for sponsoring today's feature. So here we are with Zoom, and they added a bunch of features more recently, trying to compete with the likes of Google Workspace, Microsoft 365, and even the likes of Dropbox as well. It's really become quite a competitive environment. And Zoom had that pandemic boost of being the place to do video meetings, and they want to extend that into other areas. So here we are with the traditional Zoom layout. And first things first is you can access mail up here. Now, I've actually set this up, so naturally I can just view it. And this is connected to my Gmail account. Although I think you can add multiple Gmail experiences and also other accounts. So here we are, you can create a Zoom Mail account or sign in with Microsoft if you did want to, and that helps to connect up. Now you can also set up some email preferencing, for example, what notifications you want popping up or undo sendabilities and even modify your signature too. And this naturally pulls itself in from Gmail. You can add third-party email experiences like Gmail and Microsoft 365, as well as remove them here. Now I'm just gonna pop this away and make this slightly bigger to give you a better idea of the real estate. Now inside of this account, what's quite nice as well is you can have filters set up. So if I wanted to add a filter, I could set it up from a subject, a criteria on what it contains, or a size of file as well. So I didn't expect them to have a feature like this being available in here, and you can also set up vacation mode here. Now, sometimes when you're using apps like Superhuman that use a third-party version of Gmail, it doesn't allow you to do things like vacation or email signature, and this is handy having that in here, because sometimes, and only rarely obviously because you do on vacation, not as much as you do say actively work, it's easier to go inside of Gmail, but this actually brings it all into one house. So let's go back and give you an idea of what the account looks like. And to be honest, it looks very much like Gmail. You can go inside of an email and see the details of it. You can reply, you can do all of the regular stuff up here, and you can even reply in line. And it gives you very much what Gmail gives you from the start, but ported inside of Zoom. Composing an email can be done in the top right, the bottom right hand corner, and you can see that it actually brings in my Gmail, my old Gmail setup for my work, and this helps you to create a new email. Now, well, to be honest, it's nothing special. It is really just a ported version of Gmail, but it is nice having it all toasted into one area. Now, you can actually manage this through your account portal on the likes of zoom.com, which you can manage there, which gives you a lot more control about what you have access to and things like that. Now, the same goes for your email experience. You can, your calendar experience. You can now see a view of what's coming up. You can create events. And if I'm able just to make the screen slightly smaller, you can see the details of everything that comes up. Now, as you can see, I'm on the Zoom One basic plan, so I have a 40-minute limit. But what it will can do is go ahead and create an event, a Zoom meeting straight away, and naturally create a password, send it to the right people, which is definitely a great way to do that. There is a feature called Find a Time, which allows you to pick a variety of slots to be able to book in, but they do have a fairly new feature that is in beta called Zoom Scheduler. So I'm gonna just log into my Zoom account and show you how to get access to that. So here is the Zoom Scheduler. You can create a public page much like Calendly and go ahead and create a repeat availability or a custom availability, creating the event and setup like that. This is helpful for maybe those who do routine webinars, book PT sessions, or maybe even those who are consultancy based. This is quite helpful for creating a repeat schedule where people can book stuff. And from here, you can see upcoming meetings that have been scheduled and anything that you want to be able to manage your public page. Your public page looks a little bit like this. I don't think it will actually have available appointments because I don't have any there, but let's just see if I can go ahead and create one. So if I refresh the page, I can now see it in very much a Calendly-like view of upcoming meetings, which could be quite helpful. Okay, so the calendar experience is fairly easy to set up, and you can do a meet now or copy your personal meeting ID from Zoom straight away, which is great for just getting things set up. You can also see a week view and a day view as well to give you a basic structure of that account. Now you can also see details of each of the events and upcoming ones in your calendar by scrolling across as well, which is really nice and easy to do. And you can even hide that side panel if you didn't want to. So as you can see, it's very basic. Zoom Mail and Zoom Calendar designed to give you a very simplistic experience, but really just a ported version of what you already have inside of your other your Zoom account, which is really helpful for being able to keep everything in one location. But to be honest, Zoom aren't offering something incredibly good here, but they're offering something that gives them an opportunity to compete with the other big players. So if I were you, I wouldn't necessarily jump on Zoom Mail and Zoom Calendar, but if you're somebody that actively uses Zoom to book meetings, to manage webinars, and even use the relatively new whiteboard function, this might be something you might want to bring into one location. If you're looking for consolidation, this is probably a good move, but if you're looking for a practicality in day-to-day use and you are already using something else, I wouldn't necessarily move to something like this. So that was an overview of Zoom Mail and Zoom Calendar. Hopefully the guide gave you a bit of an overview of what they're like, whether they're worth it, and a little bit more about it. So thank you very much for joining today. If you want to subscribe, you can check us out below. If you want to find Toolfinder and find the perfect productivity app for you, you can find that link in the description below. Thank you very much, folks, and I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Cheerio.